Hello, welcome to the Top Shelf, my Criterion DVD review series. Thank you for hanging out this long. Here we are at episode 5. My name is Ernest Whiteman III. I'm a Northern Arapaho filmmaker, artist, writer, and media educator. And what we'll do now is review one of my DVDs from the Top Shelf. We pick one at random. I'll give you a quick synopsis, some of the DVD extras, a review on whether I liked it or not, if I viewed it, and maybe why I purchased this particular disc. So let's get started. I believe we're up with this hand again. So let's pick one at random. This one right here. All right. Tokyo Story by Yasujiro Ozu, one of my great, great favorite movies of all time. Yasujiro Ozu was someone who was not really particularly familiar with, even when I went to film school. I think we viewed a couple of his. The first thing I remember seeing was Good Morning. And this one stars the great Setsuko Hara, actress I admire greatly, and Chisu Ryu, one of his great collaborators through his years, from his silent films to his final films. Tells the story of a family, a pair of parents who go to visit their children in Tokyo. And while no one has time for them, the only one that makes time for them is a daughter-in-law who married into the family, played by Setsuko Hara. And then the family has to go back to Katakura because the mother falls ill. And it's a great, works on all of his themes of generational differences. This time it's three generations of grandparents, parents, and the grandchildren, and extended family like the in-laws. It's a great, it's considered his masterpiece. So let me read a little bit of the back for you. This one is a first print. It's a two-disc collector's set. The first one has a newly restored high-definition transfer, audio commentary by Ozu film scholar David Desser, the original theatrical trailer, and new subtitles. The second disc is I Lived But, which came out in 1983. It's a two-hour documentary about the life and career of Ozu, which I watch and highly recommend that if you get it, to watch it as well. Talking with Ozu is a 40-minute tribute that has various different filmmakers coming in to talk about him, giving their opinions on his work. It's a really good movie. This one is the one that moved me the most and made me a huge fan of Ozu. I have since tried to collect more of his and try to reach and watch more of his. I love his style of... he's always breaking the 180-degree rule. He shoots from the tatami mat shot, which is like about three feet off the ground. And everybody always looks directly into the camera when they're in discussion, which is a very cool, very unique style that to shoot in. And the reason I bought this is, again, I saw this on Hulu when they were offering Criterion films for free during some periods, and I just fell in love with the story, fell in love with Setsuko Hara as always. So yeah, that's the reason why I have this film. I have two copies, so I might come around and talk about it again later on if I pick it at random. This is spine number 217. Thanks for joining. I'll see you again next time.